Hello everybody, I am Tom and you are going to be watching me react to the new Dragon Age trailer, Dragon Age and Veilguard. I hope it's good, but I've just noticed this. So, we'll see. We'll see.
Looking good, old friend.
This'll
take more than you and me.
That's Varric, right? And Harding. I vaguely know Harding. Just in Inquisition,
right?
We
need someone to be our eyes and ears in the shadows.
And someone to bring a little darkness to the daylight.
We're going into the Fade, aren't we?
Digging up a lot of buried secrets.
What about Darkspawn?
Yeah. Someone who will stand between us and a pack of demons.
You know there will be dragons.
Right. We'll need someone with fire in their blood. One more thing. This crew needs a leader. Someone we can count on. Someone that the world can count on. But where are we gonna find her?
Interesting. I mean, it didn't look good. I understand the thumbs down now. It doesn't feel like Dragon Age at all. Is this the, like, official game? Or is this... This feels like a spin-off. Upcoming action role-playing video game developed by BioWare. The fourth major game in the Dragon Age franchise. Sequel to Dragon Age Inquisition. I mean, I don't get it. Why is it tonally so weird? Not only the footage, also game engine footage implies this is what the game's gonna look like as far as art style, which is just, it doesn't look like Dragon Age for starters. Dragon Age originally was dark fantasy. Inquisition took it a bit more into high fantasy, but there was still like dark fantasy in there, specifically with the expansion and stuff. But this seems like, feels like, I don't know, for want of a better term, the art style is more like Fortnite. It looks like a Fortnite crossover is what it feels like. It's weird. Also, the tone of the writing, it's very kind of lighthearted and, like, that could just be the trailer, I guess. But the tone of the writing seems weird, but, like, this is Varric. That definitely looks like Varric. And I think Harding was, she was, like, the lead scout in Inquisition, I think, from memory. Let me Google that to confirm. Yes. Lace Harding. She was the scout woman. I do remember her. So I remember her.
Not looking good, old friend.
She looks vaguely normal. She looks vaguely normal. She's well proportioned. I mean, a dwarf, but he looks like he's from, like, Sea of Thieves. It's like, it looks almost cel-shaded. It's very weird. There's something off about him. I can't quite put my finger on it.
Someone to be our eyes and ears in the shadows.
She kind of looks all right as well. She looks vaguely normally proportioned. And, like, the art style in between characters seems oddly inconsistent. Also, these kind of nameplate things, again, it's weird hero. It's like superhero vibe, which is weird.
And someone to bring a little darkness to the daylight.
The mage killer. Again, he looks more like Vary. He looks more cartoony. Very strange. This scene here looks like Dragon Age to me. Like with the lighting and the environments, this screams Dragon Age. And then this doesn't. This seems like, I don't know, it's like a Pixar character. It's
going
weird.
Into the fade, aren't we?
She also seems a bit too happy coming out of the fade, to be honest. There we go, again. Go back to these faces. This one, vaguely normal. This one looks kind of weird. Like, too cartoonish.
And digging up a lot of buried...
This, insanely cartoonish. He looks like a villain out of a Pixar movie.
Secrets.
Although I do like the idea of a necromancer as a companion. I assume these are the companions is what we're going through here.
What about Darkspawn?
Yeah.
He looks all right, character model wise.
Someone will stand.
Wait, what? Is that a darkspawn? I mean, come on, come the fuck on! Look at that. Is that supposed to be a fucking darkspawn ogre? Like,
stand between us.
You're kidding, right?
And a pack of
this thing looks alright. It's a griffin. That makes sense because I think we never really had them in the previous games, but it was always talked about that the Grey Wardens had griffin companions all the time. So that's cool lore wise, I guess. But the Darkspawn looks goofy as fuck. Again, she looks alright. She looks normal.
Dragons.
He looks almost cel-shaded. There's something really weird. It's like so inconsistent.
Right.
Dragon looks pretty good.
We'll need someone.
Cartoon character. Also, she doesn't look like a Kunari. She's too slim. Like, even the female Kunari. I mean, I guess you don't have... She's only next to a dragon for scale. So maybe she's massive. And she'd have to be, you'd hope.
One with five.
Also, I can't remember the way that women were portrayed in the Kin, but I'm pretty sure.
Fire in their blood. One more thing. This crew needs a leader. Someone we can count on. Someone that the world can count on.
Also kind of playing the main character winning here off as a joke. I mean, maybe just trailer type shit, obviously, but like...
But where are we gonna find her?
See, look at the comparison here. This looks like a good graphics of a dwarf female. This... He doesn't look real. It's like the lighting hits him in all the wrong spots. It's... I can't quite put my finger on it. But they look like they're, if you cover one and then cover the other one, they look like they're from different games. And this feels like a fucking ad for League of Legends. I mean, I guess I hold out until June 11th, where we get a gameplay premiere, maybe. But I feel like the gameplay, ever since Origins, I haven't really liked the gameplay of Dragon Age games that much. I'm playing for the story and the characters, right? Origins, fantastic gameplay, fantastic story. Dragon Age 2, I quite liked the story and where it went with it. But the game just wasn't finished. Like, I think that there was like 5 environments in the entire game and you just played through them a bunch. But I liked the idea of Dragon Age 2 taking the story down to a singular person and their story of becoming a hero. That was a cool story. I liked it. It's definitely a step down from the kind of very high fantasy of playing a Grey Warden, the savior of the universe in the first game, obviously. But I quite liked it. And I liked the way that it was kind of told through Varric's perspective as a story and all that kind of stuff. And then Dragon Age Inquisition changed the tone quite a bit, at least for the base game. I mean, I guess Corypheus is kind of dark fantasy still, just by the very nature of him. He's kind of dark fantasy, but it moved a bit away from dark fantasy into high fantasy, but I still really like Dragon Age Inquisition. The biggest problem I have with Dragon Age Inquisition is they went too many ways with the gameplay is my biggest problem with it. I still like the story a bunch. I really like the story, particularly all the stuff with Solas. But I think the gameplay was weird in Dragon Age Inquisition. Like, it felt like a single player MMO at times. Like, there were too many fetch quests type deals. And they had that weird system with the wait real time for your Inquisition thing going on. I'm like, why does this exist? That seems a bit silly. So there were some weird things gameplay wise in Inquisition. But for the most part, I enjoyed it. Still, like the game in both 2 and Inquisition, the gameplay was passable. It was probably a bit better in Inquisition than it was in Dragon Age 2, in my opinion. But Dragon Age Origins still has the best gameplay by far, and arguably the best story by far. But the other two were both really good in story, so I really enjoyed them, right? So this could be really shit gameplay wise and really shit graphically. As long as they pull the story off, I'll be happy. But the people who wrote the story for all the previous ones don't even fucking work at BioWare anymore. So I don't have high hopes for that either. I don't know. I'll wait for the gameplay reveal. It's June 11th, which is tomorrow for me, but I assume that's in 2 days because that'll be probably in Pacific Standard Time. So it'll be probably sometime in the morning of the 12th for me. Just for comparison, you take this kind of tone and then you compare it to this. All right, we're back. Compared to this, right?
Legend says the tomb sits atop this peak.
Lovely. We can freeze to death while digging for the bones of a madwoman.
Longest time since I've seen this. This still holds up. This thing's shit. This shit is so cool.
Kill the emissary.
You're getting multiple reactions out of me now because I get to see this again.
The righteous stand before the darkness, and the Maker shall guide their hand.
Steady.
Oh, corpse explosion. I love it.
Oh.
Look at that Darkspawn. Way cooler. Darkspawn ogre there compared to the one in the other one. This was Dragon Age. Even in number 2 and 3, this is Dragon Age, right? 3 took it away a bit, but not much. Look at that shit. Fucking gold. I'm gonna like this. Good. I'm gonna like their 11-year-old trailer and dislike the one they released today. I don't know, man. I'm going to do another reaction video when the game play trailer comes out, just because I'm hoping against hope that I'm wrong. But so far, it's looking bad, man. I'm so disappointed. All right, well, let's hold that hope, right? I'm going to huff my copium right now. Maybe we'll be fine. Anyway. That's going to be it for the video. I don't know how long that'd end up being. I end up doing 2 reactions because I hadn't seen this trailer in a long ass time. And God, it's a good trailer. I mean, fuck me, it's such a good trailer. Anyway, that's going to be it. If you like the video, please leave a like, subscribe, all that kind of jazz. Let me know your opinions in the comments because I'm interested to know what other people think. But, yeah. I mean, I think just let BioWare die at this point, let's be honest. It might already be dead. Let's be frank. Oh, I'm out, guys. So.